now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And so we come now to the second glorious mystery, our Lord's ascension into heaven. Let me share with you a meditation taken from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Then Jesus said to the 11, "Thus it is written that the Messiah must first suffer and rise from the dead on the third day. In his name, penance for the remission of sins is to be preached to all the nations, beginning at Jerusalem. You are witnesses of this. See, I send down upon you the promise of my Father. Remain here in the city until you are clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out near Bethany, and with his hands upraised, he blessed them. As he blessed them, he left them and was taken up into heaven. They fell down to do him reverence and then returned to Jerusalem filled with joy. There they were to be found in the temple, constantly speaking the praises of God. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And so we come now to the third glorious mystery, the descent of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost. And I share with you a meditation taken from the Acts of the Apostles. When the day of Pentecost came, it found them gathered together in one place. Suddenly, from up in the sky, there came a noise like a strong, driving wind, which was heard all through the house where they were seated. Tongues as of fire appeared, and they parted and came to rest on each of them. All were filled with the Holy Spirit. Then they began to express themselves in foreign tongues and make bold proclamations as the Spirit prompted them. Staying in Jerusalem at that time were devout Jews of every nation under heaven. These heard the sound and assembled in a large crowd. They were much confused because each of them heard them speaking in their own language. The whole occurrence astonished them. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And so we come now to the fourth glorious mystery, the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary into heaven. And I share with you a meditation taken from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Then Mary said, "My being proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit finds joy in God my Savior, for he has looked upon his lowly servant. All generations shall call me blessed. God, who is mighty, has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He has shown the strength of his arm, and he has confused the proud in their inmost thoughts. He has deposed the mighty from their thrones, and raised up the lowly to high places. The hungry he has given every good thing, while the rich he has sent away empty. He has upheld Israel, his servant, ever mindful of his mercy, even as he promised our fathers, promised Abraham and his descendants forever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And so we come to the fifth glorious mystery, the coronation of the Blessed Virgin Mary as Queen of Heaven. And I share with you a meditation taken from the Old Testament book of Judith. Blessed are you, daughter, by the Most High God, above all the women on earth, and blessed be the Lord our God, the Creator of heaven and earth. Your deed of hope will never be forgotten by those who tell of the might of God. May God make this redound to your everlasting honor, rewarding you with blessings because you risked your life when your people were being oppressed, and you averted our disaster, walking uprightly before our God. And all the people answered, Amen, Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercies, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy toward us. And after this, our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We'll continue with the funeral liturgy in just a few minutes.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the community of St. Mary and St. Anne. I invite everyone to stand now and join in singing our gathering song. If you have a worship aid, it can be found on the inside page on Eagle's Wings.
And he will raise you up on Eagle's Wings, bear you on the breath of God, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hands. You need to dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hands. The snare of the Father will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, hold you in the palm of his hands. You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. Though thousands fall about you, near you it shall not come. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. To his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hands, and hold you in the palm of his hands.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our risen Savior, Jesus Christ, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, in the waters of baptism, Carol died with Christ. May she now rise with him to share new and everlasting life. Amen. My friends, we believe that the ties of friendship and kinship that knit us together as one throughout the course of our lives do not unravel at the time of death. Instead, we are confident in God's mercy, confident that God listens and hears our prayers. And so we gather this day to pray for Carol. We ask that God accept her tenderly into his mercy, and so let us bow our heads and pray. God of our ancestors in faith, By the covenant made on Mount Sinai, you taught your people to strengthen the bonds of family through faith, honor, and love. Look kindly now upon Carol, a mother who sought to bind her children to you. Bring her one day to our heavenly home, where all the saints dwell in blessedness and peace. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite the assembly to be seated now as we prepare to hear our first reading from Sacred Scripture.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For in the eyes of men, indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they should be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful should abide in him, with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My light and my salvation, of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid? The Lord is my light and my salvation, of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid?
The Lord is my light and my help. Whom should I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Before whom should I shrink?
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid?
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, for this I long, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
The Lord is my light and my salvation, of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid?
I believe I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Hope in him and take heart. Hope in the Lord.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Of whom should I be afraid? Of whom should I be afraid?
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, no one lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or we die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother? Or you, why do you look down on your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seal of God, for it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then each of us shall give an account of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be unto God.
Jesus then answered, saying to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life, and I will not come and will not come to condemnation, but is passed from death to life. Amen, amen, I say to you, the hour is coming and is now here, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so also he gave life to the Son the possession of life in himself. And he gave him power to exercise judgment, because he is the Son of Man. Do not be amazed at this, because the hour is coming in which all who are in the tombs will hear his voice and will come out. Those who have done good deeds to the resurrection of life, those who have done wicked deeds to the resurrection of condemnation. My brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. I want to begin my thoughts this morning first by expressing to Carol's family, most especially to her daughters, to her siblings, to other family members who are gathered here today, and to this larger community of friends, co-workers who knew Carol. I want to begin simply by saying to you that you have been in our prayers, you've been in our thoughts here in our parish community, and I want to extend to you our most profound and heartfelt condolences. To lose someone in such a sudden way can be a very trying experience. And then to lose someone who had such a pivotal role in your family can be even more challenging. I also want to say thank you to the members of the family who took time with me just a couple days ago to give me the opportunity to get to know Carol just a little bit better. Although when Mason walked in, I knew exactly who Carol was, because they would come in communion. See, my station for communion is normally right here. And Carol and Mason would come right down this line at communion time, and Carol would receive communion and make sure that Mason crossed his arms in order to receive the blessing. They were here practically every Saturday or Sunday. It was like clockwork. It goes without saying, based on that, that faith was really important to Carol. And she tried to share that with everyone who she met and everyone whom she loved, because that gift was shared with her from the very beginning of her life. I didn't ask, but I'm guessing Ackley is an Irish name. English? Okay, close enough. Yeah, it's an ish name. Obviously a family filled with great faith. And the reason that's important is that I'm guessing that Carol was probably baptized very soon after her birth. That was a very strong tradition in Irish, English, Scottish, Catholic families. Come out of the hospital, go straight to church to have that baby baptized. Yeah. And that's important because that was literally a gift that was being handed on to Carol as it's handed on to each person who's baptized. That's how important that gift to faith is to families. Come to church, have that baby baptized, start raising them as a boy, as a girl of faith. Let them grow in God's love from those very first moments of life. That important gift was given to Carol at the very beginning of her life. And we recalled that gift very beautifully and very simply at the very beginning of this liturgy, as I used holy water to sprinkle, a reminder of baptism, a reminder of Carol's baptism. Beyond life, that gift of baptism, that gift of faith, was perhaps the most important gift that she could have been given. And in her own way, she recognized the importance of that gift, and she sought to share it in so many different ways. First with her own children, then with her grandchildren, her five little treasured grandchildren. All of that speaks first and foremost of the kind of person who's described in that first reading from the Old Testament book of Wisdom. You may know it as the Book of Wisdom. Some of you may know it as the Wisdom of Solomon. That passage that we heard this morning speaks about the souls of the just are in the very hand of God. The souls of the just. A just person is a person who recognizes that God is God, the source of all that is, and that we as human beings are part of God's handiwork. We're not God. We're called to live in relationship of love with God, who is our creator. That's a just person. God wants a close, loving relationship with just people, to hold them in the palm of his hand, to give them protection, care, and support, even when life is challenging. And we know that Carol had her own set of challenges that came during the course of her life. And God saw her through those challenges. Then in the second reading, we hear St. Paul speak so beautifully in that letter to the Romans. None of us lives for oneself, and none of us dies for oneself. In other words, the best expression of our life and living is to not be selfish or self-centered. The best expression of our life of faith and how we're called to live it is to be other-centered. Look at the needs of those around us and seek to meet those needs as best we can with what we have. There again, you have something that's reflected in Carol's life. As she looked at your lives, the lives of all of you whom she loved, and she tried to meet those needs in the best ways that she could, with her love, with her care, with her creativity, with her own generosity, with her ability to bake and to cook, but most importantly with the gift of faith that she wanted to hand on again and again and again. Carol did not live for herself. She lived for others. That was exemplified in the kind of work that she did as a nursing assistant. People who work in healthcare do not live for themselves. They live for the good of the people that they care for. They live to use the wisdom and skill and grace and insight that God has given them to help better the conditions of people who are sick or suffering, body, mind, or spirit. I know that from my own life. My mom was a registered nurse for 60 years. That could exemplify her as it exemplifies Carol, who sought to do what she could to focus her energy, her care, on the needs of people who needed help. This is exactly what Jesus calls us to do. Take care of the sick. Take care of one another. Because this is exactly how Jesus lived his life. His life was not focused on himself. His life was focused on us. His life was focused on our need. Most primarily, our need for salvation. We'd gotten ourselves into quite a fix with the choice for sin. And Jesus made the choice to unfix us from sin, to open for us the gates of heaven, to open for us a path of salvation, of redemption. And that's what the gospel author speaks of today. Placing our trust in Jesus Christ means placing our trust in the gift of life and life eternal, not only now, but in the world to come. We believe that Carol's soul is on its journey to heaven, but we also believe in the truth of those last lines of the gospel that we hear today, that for those who are just, for those who sought to follow the life of Jesus, for those who did not live for themselves but who lived for others, for those who pass on the gift of faith, there will be resurrection when soul and body are united back together and we are raised up to be our very best selves. This is exactly the mystery that Carol trusted in every day. Because that's a mystery that allows us not to live for ourselves but to live for others. Because that is a mystery rooted in faith that means even if our life is taken from us, accidentally, quickly, suddenly, we've made a positive choice for God, and we will be given life eternal. That is ultimately why we gather here today and we celebrate together the Eucharist. We celebrate this gift of communion, this very miracle in our midst that represents that gift of eternal life because it dwells in our presence eternally. The gift of Jesus' life given to us. The gift of life that was given to Carol and to all the baptized at the very beginning. A gift that was meant to be lived as you saw it lived in Carol's life. As we see it lived in the lives of the baptized and all of those who call Jesus friend. A gift that is meant to be given and shared. A gift that is also meant to lead us home to heaven. And we pray. On that day, that morning, 6 days ago now, I guess, that Jesus was right there for her in that moment. In the same way, Jesus had been right there for her in all her moments throughout her life. In the way Jesus had been the one who had given her the gift of life and the gift of faith, the one who had been there to encourage her to live that gift of life and faith, to meet the needs of others. So too we trust that Jesus was right there in that moment when Carol needed that gift the most. And Jesus could lovingly embrace her, say to her, "Well done, good and faithful servant, enter now into eternal rest." This is what brings us here today. that promise that was made at the time of baptism, brought to its reality and its fruition now, we trust. We know in faith. When death happens suddenly like this, it can rock us back on our heels. It can unmoor us from the things that are important in our lives for a time. Do not lose sight of the gifts that Carol sought to share with you. Most importantly, that gift of faith. Jesus is the rock for a reason. He's the one that we can tie ourselves to when things are difficult. But there's also the life Jesus calls us to live, which you saw exemplified through Carol. A life that was not about self, but that was ultimately about others. This is what Jesus teaches us. He teaches us to live in this way so that the reality of his kingdom might be glimpsed here and now. That it's not just a far-off, distant, hoped-for reality, but that even now our world can be changed and can reflect his goodness. We trust in that because that's what Carol trusted in. Or perhaps I should say, because that's who Carol trusted in. And so even as we experience a sense of sadness and of loss, I do hope that in time there will be that sense of completion for Carol and for you, that she's been gently gathered home. True, much more soon than any of us would have wished. But this is why that gift of baptism was given to her at the very beginning of her life, in anticipation of a day like this. It's also important for us to do what we can to share that gift with others. One thing that you know is that Carol was a good prayer. She had lots of people to pray for, so that helps. But she was a good prayer. She lifted your needs, your cares and concerns up to God in the ways that she could. We believe now that as Carol enters in her journey home to heaven, that prayer is her one single responsibility, to pray for all of you, to perceive your needs, perhaps in a slightly different way, and to lift those needs up to the very face of God, to offer those continued prayers for you. She doesn't live for herself. She lives for others, and we pray she lives with God. And so even as we can trust that Carol now continues to offer that gift of prayer for you, it is only right and just that we should continue our prayer for her. And so I invite the assembly to stand now for the prayers of the faithful. Trusting in God's goodness and mercy, together now we give voice to our prayers for the needs of our community, our church, and for our world. And in peace we pray, responding, Lord, hear our prayer.
In baptism, Carol received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our sister Carol was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our family have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love. and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Carol's family and friends seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are all assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister, Carol. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's return. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord our God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant to them a place in your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite the assembly to be seated now for the preparation of the altar and the presentation of the gifts of bread and wine.
Ave Maria,
And so pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Lord, look favorably on our offerings, so that your departed servant Carol may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in Christ the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel or be seated, as is your custom. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts that we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Thank you. the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Anne and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Earl, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Carol, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in the resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Together we pray for the coming of God's kingdom in the words our Savior has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For communion, there will be two stations distributing the precious body. I'll be at this station here serving both these sections, so if you would form two lines here in this aisle, returning by the outside ends of your rows. For this section over here, there will be a Eucharistic minister here on this side. If you would come down this side in a single file, and then return by that inside aisle. For communion, those who are Catholic and able to receive communion are welcome to do so in the usual fashion. For those who may not be Catholic or who may be unable to receive communion today, I invite you to come forward in that same procession. And when you reach me or Terry, the other Eucharistic minister, cross your arms over your chest like this in order to receive a blessing.
Solidary communion, make me a channel of your peace.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's not true faith in you, make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life. Make me a channel of the peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Please join in singing Be Not Afraid.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. If you pass through raging waters in the sea, you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you. Blessed are your poor, for the kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are you that weep and mourn, for one day you shall laugh. And if wicked tongues insult and hate you, all because of me. Blessed are you. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Carol, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal Sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite the assembly to be seated for a few moments. And I think Stephen would like to offer some words in memory of Carol. Is that right? Robert, okay. Got my signals crossed there. Where is he? There he is. So come on right up here to the anvil, please, Robert.
Hi, I'm Robert, or as my Aunt Carol called me, Robert. Very sad today, but feel very privileged to have been asked to speak to you today as we honor Carol's memory and celebrate her life. I'm going to read some very beautiful and kind words her co-workers and others that knew her and were touched by Carol's gentle heart have left on her tribute wall. But first, I'd like to share a couple things of my own. I have so many great memories of conversations, most having to do with MSU, Go Green, or baseball, as she was an enormous fan of both. Often her first words to me when I'd see her would be about MSU football, basketball, or the Tigers, depending on the time of year. But my greatest memory, and the way I'll always remember my Aunt Carol, is her smiling and laughing, and the sound of her laugh, and I think that's how she would want. Jeff Peters wrote, Carol will live on forever in our hearts. I think that's a good way to start. JT, I will miss you, your smile, and your giggles. Peace, my friend. Linda Ifall wrote, Carol's committed faith will be my forever memory. She comforted me in 2001 after the death of both my parents by buying me the Mercy Me CD I can only imagine. She was always giving to others, which usually included chocolate cookies. I will find solace knowing that Carol shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Luann Frazzini writes, we meet many people in our lives, but very few make a lasting impression on our minds and in our hearts. I am fortunate because I can say I have met one of those people. I will miss saying good morning to you. I will miss coming out of my office to have our daily chats. I will miss saying have a good night to you. As I am leaving the office, I will simply miss you. Those who touched our lives stay in our hearts forever. Good night, my dear friend. I will see you again. Mandy Moneypenny, I am so thankful God sent a wonderful, loving, caring person in my life. I knew I always could run to you for advice and support. I am going to miss the times we had shared together. I will always have you in my heart. Mary Kleeman wrote, Dear family, Carol was my best work buddy at Sparrow for many years through the good times and the bad. She was a faithful friend. She had three girls, as did I, and we shared their trials and tributes. I remember a story she told about the girls pulling a little red wagon down the lane and stopping at Grandma's car to throw in a dead squirrel. I don't think this really goes after, but she was a wonderful cook. and often brought us treats to the office. I still have many of her recipes. She was the most faithful Christian I've ever known, so I know she is resting in the arms of the angels now. My deepest sympathies, and God bless you all. I will always remember her. Peace and love. Lori Strickland writes, I am heartbroken by Carol's passing. I had the pleasure of working with her for over 20 years, and she was always my go-to person if I had a question. I knew she would have the answer. If I had to describe Carol in one word, it would be generous. If a coworker or patient had a need, she would do her best to help in whatever way she could. So many times she would quietly provide clothing, toys, diapers for patients who had a need. She would do anything for anyone. She lived her faith. I have no doubt that when she entered into the presence of God, he said, well done, my good and faithful servant. My heartfelt condolences to her family. She loved you all so much. Sita Alam writes, Carol, I hope you rest in peace. You will be remembered for your bright smile and generosity. Thank you for the wonderful memories. God bless. Amy Downs writes, certain people in life leave a lasting impression on our hearts and positively impact our lives. Carol, my true friend and beloved colleague, this is you. I will miss you terribly. Your contagious laugh and beautiful smile will forever be remembered. An amazing and genuine person with a kind spirit and a heart of gold, I am so grateful and privileged to have known you. Thank you for teaching me so many things and for always making days a little brighter. Scott Kincaid writes, I'll miss you so much. You taught me so much and gave so much to everyone. You're always a friend and I consider you family. The world is truly a better place because of you. I'll never forget you. I'm so grateful for the time we had together. You are loved. Rest in peace, my friend. Liz Foster writes, I'm so thankful that you were part of my life. We all knew you by your thoughtfulness, knowledge, and generosity. Boy, do you love those grandkids. Thanks for sharing your thoughts, your time, and lots of laughs with me. I will miss you. Jen Kincaid, my heartfelt condolences to all who knew and loved Carol. She was a wonderful, caring, and kind person who will be greatly missed. Thank you, everybody, for those comments. They're beautiful. Thank you.
In a few moments, we'll begin what are called the prayers of commendation. These are the prayers that begin to bring this Mass to its conclusion. We won't be going to a cemetery today. Carol is to be interred at a later date. Following the conclusion with the blessing and dismissal, on behalf of Carol's family, you're all invited to a luncheon that's prepared and waiting in our parish hall here at St. Mary. To get to that, just go back out into the gathering space where you entered. As you come out the doors of the church in the gathering space area, turn right and head all the way down the gathering space toward the double doors that lead to the parish hall and gym. And you'll find the luncheon prepared and waiting for you there. The luncheon serves a couple of important purposes. One, it helps to nourish hunger that we feel at this time of the day. The second is far more important, though. It provides an opportunity for you to share stories of how Carol touched your lives in so many ways. I want you to share those stories with the family as much as possible. Yes, there might be laughter, and sometimes there may be tears, that's true. But those stories that you share with them are a priceless gift that you give them. They may learn things about Carol that they never knew, and certainly you'll have an opportunity to share those with them to help them on their journey of grief that begins. And those stories then will be things that they can hang on to. And please don't hesitate to tell those stories, not just today, but in the days and weeks and months ahead. It is one of the most important ways that you can help this family now with their grief, is to journey with them in just that way. Let us stand now for the prayers of commendation. Trusting in God, together we have prayed for Carol, and now we come to a time of farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we also take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Carol again and enjoy the continued gift of her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, God's mercy will gather us together again in the joy of the kingdom. Therefore, let us continue to console one another in the faith of Christ Jesus, and let us pray. May the angels welcome you to paradise. May the martyrs greet you on your way. May you see the face of the Lord this day.
Alleluia!
Alleluia!
May the angels welcome you to paradise. May the martyrs greet you on your way. May you see the face of the Lord this day. Alleluia, alleluia.
Saints of God, come and lead you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
Alleluia, alleluia. May the angels welcome you to paradise. May the martyrs greet you on your way. May you see the face of the Lord this day.
Alleluia,
alleluia.
Hallelujah. And so into your hands, Father of Mercies, we lovingly commend our sister Carol, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for blessings bestowed on Carol in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with all the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister Carol forever. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. In the sure and certain hope of the resurrection, together now we take leave of our sister Carol, and we go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Absolutely.